Is your baby getting too much aluminum? Aluminum is a metal that seems harmless. We wrap our food in it and we cook with it. It also occurs naturally in the environment, so we swallow aluminum in food and water every day. There's aluminum in breast milk and even more in baby formula. And aluminum is harmless, unless it gets into our bloodstream. Because aluminum is a neurotoxin, like mercury and lead, and it kills brain cells. Fortunately, most of the aluminum we swallow passes harmlessly out through our intestinal tract. But what exactly happens to the aluminum that gets absorbed into our bloodstream? Some deposits in our bones and brain, especially if we get too much all at once. You may have heard that injected aluminum is just as harmless as swallowed aluminum. But research tells us that's wrong. The FDA first learned that injected aluminum was neurotoxic 20 years ago. Doctors found that hospitalized babies being fed through IVs received 50 micrograms of aluminum each day, which impaired their neurological and mental development. This is why the FDA now requires warning labels on IV solutions and medications, and put a limit of 25 micrograms on every IV feeding bag used in hospitals. Remember that number, 25 micrograms. We'll come back to it. What would you say if you found out that almost every baby in America receives over 1,200 micrograms of aluminum in vaccines at every infant checkup? That's 50 times the FDA safety limit. And it happens 3 times in just the first 6 months. Even at birth, all babies get 10 times the FDA safety limit of aluminum in one hepatitis B shot. Did your doctor inform you about these risks when you authorized your baby's vaccinations? Of course not. Because, believe it or not, your doctor probably doesn't even know. Vaccines contain aluminum, and lots of it. Without it, vaccines wouldn't work very well, because aluminum triggers a stronger immune response. But no one has been allowed to research the safety of vaccine aluminum in human babies because it's too toxic. Instead, some doctors tell us that we eat and drink far more aluminum than we ever get from vaccines. And since we've been using it in vaccines for over 70 years, it must be safe. But now you know this isn't true. Because while what we swallow passes out of us harmlessly, all of what we inject goes into our bloodstream. Why does the FDA limit aluminum to 25 micrograms in hospitals, but allow babies to get 1,225 micrograms in shots at every baby checkup? All scientific and government regulatory agencies state that aluminum is toxic to the brain. So why is this dangerous amount of aluminum not being regulated in vaccines? Asking questions about vaccine safety doesn't make you anti-vaccine. It means that you want your babies to be vaccinated safely. Brought to you by the Immunity Education Group, a non-profit organization.